Big Savage in the building, the grind don't stop unless it kill me. Y'all already know, welcome to the Savage Nation. Make sure to hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't. And today, we got some major news in the Call of Duty world. Yes, it is confirmed. Microsoft has bought Activision Blizzard for $70 billion. Now, I know what you're thinking. I woke up, I saying the same thing. I was like, holy shit! What the fuck is going on here? I know Call of Duty was doing bad, but goddamn, is that bad? It must be. And the time has came. Call of Duty is no longer independent. They finally sold that thing. And the question of the day is, will this help Call of Duty? Will this be a good thing, or will Xbox and PC steal Call of Duty from everyone else? And I'ma just put it on record, they done already put out a statement, and they said that they aware that Activision and Blizzard have users on multiple platforms, and they don't plan on changing that and making it just exclusive to Xbox and PC. So, if you a PlayStation boy like me, then you're safe. You're safe. They're not going to steal a game and make it exclusive to them. We don't got to switch consoles or none of that. Cool. Now, the main reason I'm kind of skeptical about this move, Microsoft just literally said that they was going to have to rethink their relationship with Activision because of the Bobby Kotick accusations and all that mess going on with the sexual assault cases. So, was rethinking their relationship buying them out and then saying that Bobby is here to stay, even after everything is over with? They already confirmed and said that Bobby ain't going nowhere. So what the fuck is really going on? Did Microsoft just bail Bobby out? Is that what happened? We can very much say that that's going on. I mean, come on, look at the trends. Activision has been very, very greedy recently. I mean, they just announced, a $200 million bonus not too long ago. Now they just sold everything for $70 billion and Bobby gets to stay? Now who would pass up on that deal? I don't think no one would. Does this say Call of Duty is saved now that Microsoft steps in? I don't think so. I think Microsoft's moving their chess pieces. Microsoft working, they don't give a fuck. And Activision just got their ass saved like a newborn baby that was about to get chomped up by an alligator. Microsoft just swooped right in and grabbed their ass up. Now for the companies and the business, this is great. You know, it helps them out. It benefits both sides. But for the consumers, for the gamers, for the players, this is fucking trash. This is trash. It's only gonna make the integrity of the game worse. Now don't get me wrong. When I'm speaking, I'm talking about Call of Duty specifically. They might have some other titles that might do really great on this side of things. But for Call of Duty, I see nothing good coming from it. One thing that we also have confirmed is Call of Duty will be on Game Pass day one. Day one. Now I want to know, what do you think about that? With Call of Duty and Activision being so greedy and so fucking shameless, I could really see them just scooping for the bare minimum. They already been giving us Call of Duties unfinished and doing all these updates and patches throughout the year and then kind of getting the game together towards the end. So what's really stopping them from keeping this going? I mean, they already showed us that they don't care. They already about to get paid way more, so it don't even matter, essentially. And they still gonna make money and be in the positions that they was in. Calling the shots, dropping all these bundles, getting all this money that they been doing from the past. And they been making way more on Call of Duty than they was when they was actually caring about the game and giving us good titles. So what will this change? I say nothing. I say not a damn thing. Now this whole deal was announced and everything, but the good thing about it, or maybe even the bad thing about it, if this deal turns out to help us, it won't take effect until June 2023. So we still gonna get, you know, the second version of Modern Warfare that's coming out next year, and the integration of that with Warzone and everything. All that is still going down, just as scheduled. So we got another year of Activision bullshit, of them being alone and all that, and their already trend and pattern of giving us trash ass games. Now, so far, that's everything that we got confirmed, but there's definitely some questions that are still in the air that everybody is thinking right now. Number one for me being the COD and Halo collaboration. Will they finally go ahead and just do it? These are the number one and two first-person shooters on the market right now. It would be insane if the company that owns both of them didn't do a bundle or something, or, you know, some type of DLC, or maybe even a game putting them together somehow. I don't know. We're going to have to wait and see. What do y'all think about that, though? And another question is, now that Microsoft will be running things, will Call of Duty still have its yearly release? I know Bobby's still going to be around, but will they step in and say, no, have some integrity in your game and take 2 years or maybe even three before you drop the next one? That might save the day right there. That's all we need. I mean, just think about it. A recent Call of Duty where they actually took the time to test everything before they released it to the public. Oh my God. Like, damn. To think that that was so hard nowadays. To think that they would be going backwards. And now, the only thing I could do is just hope and wish deep down inside of me that this is not another backwards move for Call of Duty. You know, I just hope they get all the money they need to actually give a fuck about this game and give a fuck about how this game is affecting other people's lives, from regular players and kids to content creators around the world. Will Call of Duty finally give us that good classic feel? I don't know. We gonna have to wait and see though. Let me know what y'all think down below in the comment section. I really think nothing too much gonna change, but deep down, like I said, I'm hoping that I'm wrong. I really am. So, appreciate everybody coming through. I'm gonna get at y'all in the next one. Shout out to the Savage Nation. Peace!
I hate Nashi.
I spent the light 10. I got the pipe in. Gonna spin a block, no type in. I just want the face like we Skype in. Can't cut no hoe, they be trifling.